Hello. Quite the cozy setup you have here. I'll just make myself comfortable. Thank you so much. I was just settling in and reviewing my latest findings. Mind flayers, cultists, and, of course, your esteemed company. Why, I'm practically an expert. They've tentacles, you know. Quite shocking. The druid Halson had some kind of mind flayer specimen in a jar in his quarters. A replica, no doubt, but truly fascinating to see up close. As a matter of fact, I do. But why do you? That's quite impossible. You'd have undergone ceramorphosis by now. I can't attest to the specifics, but I do know that not long after insertion, the host, that's you, turns into a mind flayer. As there's not a tentacle on your head, I can only assume you haven't been infected. If what you say were true, you'd be a mind flayer by now. You? Infected by a mind flayer? Ridiculous. Isn't it? Perhaps that's for the best. I'd be irresponsible not to debunk such a strange claim. If I just peer in your eye, I could quickly... Oh, dear sweet gods! I mean, yes. I suppose I can. I'll need to research the particulars, however. Give me a bit of time, and I'll have this little issue sorted.
Well met. Make some room, and I'm all yours.
Yes. Darling, I'm hurt. I thought we had something special. I guess I'll spend my evenings lounging here while you do all the hard work. It sounds awful.
Well met. That's the spirit.
Thank you. Ah, another. Thy name has been recorded. I shall be here in thy camp for whenever thou hast need of my services. Beyond mortal realms, there doth exist an amalgamation of spirits akin to thine own, ensnared by the treacherous cult of the Absolute, felled in its name. They bear great discontentment with their destiny. For a mere pittance of coin, I might summon the worthiest among them to lend aid to thy undertaking. Most willingly, forsooth. Their passions doth run deep for what hath been wrought upon them. Suspicion always haunts the guilty mind. My services are all that I can proffer thee. What thou wilt do with them is for thee to undertake. Should thou or any of thy compatriots perish, I will cleave soul to body once more. Because it is my calling, there is little else to explain. A matter of coin. Such is life. Outrage leading to a singular end. Then I shall wait here patiently until it is acquired.
Fate. Dost thou require a new ally?
There are many answers to that question. None are important. Correct.
No.
Shah's blessings upon you. I'm sure you do, but please try to understand that it's not something I can just talk about freely. Perhaps there's potential in you. Let's see how you handle this. I am indeed a disciple of Shah, Mistress of the Night and Lady of Loss. I assume you've heard of her. My Lady Shah is the Night Singer, the patron of darkness and loss. Most fear the dark, like children. Because in darkness they see their fears reflected. But Shah teaches us to step beyond fear, beyond loss. In darkness, we do not hide. We act. Pain, hope, the promise of better days. All of these are heavy cloaks that bend our backs and burden our hearts. We shed those cloaks. Before Shah, we stand gloriously naked. Beyond the vanities of mortals. We tear down the lies the world is drunk on. The institutions they trust, the so-called gods they worship, the lives they cling to. We destroy false idols, topple corrupt organizations, fight heretics wherever they're found. There's often suffering, death even. Many people break before they embrace Shah's truths. You're wiser than most. Many people balk at our doctrine. It's the reason why we cherish secrecy. You've a habit of saying all the right things. Either you're very glib or we're kindred spirits. Maybe both, knowing myself. But yes, once we've saved ourselves, we can talk more on this. You already know my biggest secrets. What more can you ask? She took me in when no one else would. Without her, I wouldn't be alive. She's my mother. She nurtures me, cares for me, loves me. Don't believe the lies the Saloonites tell. What, besides my life's calling and the greatest problem I've ever faced? Well, I like night orchids and can't swim. Is that the sort of thing you meant? It's nothing to laugh at. Save your questions if that's how you're going to react. No, I can't. I mean, I literally can't. There's certain things I can't remember right now. Shah's secrets must be preserved above all else. All who worship her know this. I have had certain memories suppressed, voluntarily, so that I can serve Shah without compromising her. If I manage to return to Baldur's Gate and fulfill Shah's mission, then my memories will be restored. Of course. It is an act of faith, not to be undertaken lightly. Shah will reward me when I succeed. Fine. What's on your mind? I don't think I've ever had a confidant quite like you. And if I have, I can't remember them.
One horn, the stink of Avernus, Advocatus Diaboli.
Well, I'll be gods damned. The Blade of Frontiers. Thought I'd shaken you for good. That'll teach me to underestimate you. Bloody right. An honor to be chased by the Blade of Frontiers, but I...
A great heat roars through you. Her heat, fiery as the hells. Then you're lost in visions of demonic armies as you tear through a landscape of fire and blood, the Blood War. You saw it from above as the Nautiloid passed through Avernus. This woman was on the front line.
What was that?
Evidence. Proof that you're a devil. A gladiator in the archdevil Zariel's army.
I can explain, but it's a whole situation. If you just hear me out...
Another vision. Karlak's blade raised, slicing through devils, Zariel's servants, as her eyes dart around, seeking escape. Her rage and desperation seep into you. She is a victim of the Blood War, not an agent of it.
She's trying to trick us. Don't believe her lies.
You saw the truth. I never wanted to serve Zariel. I was enlisted in her army against my will. Forced to fight, and fight I did. When I saw an opportunity to get away, I took it. Finally home. Well, near it, anyway.
You served her! That's enough to damn you!
Will catches his breath and his lips straighten. Sheer dread twists his face.
You don't know what you're saying. You're asking me to trust a devil.
Listen to sense now. I don't want this to end badly for either of us. You know monsters, right? Better than anyone. Look into my eyes. Can't you see I'm not what you think?
Shit. You really are no devil, are you? I've been deceived.
Oh, thank the gods. Thought I was gonna have to take your head.
You would have died in the attempt. But there have been enough threats today.
Truce then, eh?
Aye. Truce.
I'm Karlak. But you already knew that. And you are... Well met, soldier. Nice to meet a friendly around here. It's been tough going so far.
I may not be a devil, but I can put the Blade's reputation to work. How would you feel about helping me kill some evil bastards?
Little background, if your moral compass needs something to point at. You already know I fought in the Blood War. I was good. Really good. Turns out, I've got a knack for killing demons. That made me a valuable... asset. Zariel, the archdevil herself, made me as her personal attack dog. I played along until I could get the fuck out of there, but devils don't like to lose their assets. Zariel liked it so little. She sent a bunch of goons, so-called paladins of Tyr, to take me back. Problem is, I'm not going. Don't worry, I'll lead the charge. But I could use your help. There's a lot of them and only one of me. After that, we can team up. Take Faerun by the short hairs. Sound good? Fuck yes! They cornered me outside the toll house just up the hill. Doubt they've gone far after the scorching I gave them. Hang on though. Looks like you've got enough backup at your side. Not sure there's room for me. I'll catch up with you when it's time to camp for now. But don't get to any of the fun stuff without me. Got it?
You've been witness to a pantomime, I'm sorry to say. And I've played my part all too poorly. I can say only this. Karlak's not the only one who's had a villain's knife held to their throats.
You sound like a man with the nine hells at his heels.
You're closer than you know. One night soon, when we make camp, the veil will be lifted, and I'll pay my penance. You're not in any danger, I promise. I can't say the same about me.
Whatever it takes. salutations.
What can I do you for?
Make room, then. And hurry.
Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times. Well met.
Devil and devil hunter standing shoulder to shoulder against a common enemy. Rather poetic, I think. I question the wisdom of that decision, but so be it. I'll be here in the meantime, idling away the hours.
Quite the cozy setup you have here. Not yet, I'm afraid. But my expectations are very, very high.
Hmm? Trust me, I'll tell you all about it after we take care of the goons on my tail.
Aces.
Thank you.
what people will say, Will, when they find out the monster hunter is becoming a monster. I've always had a soft spot for the confident ones. They always disappoint, though.
No time to rest. Never wanted the easy path. Risk being in open view. Best get in and out.
Keep that beast away from us, you hear?
Me, the beast? Now that's fucking rich.
Please, no more. Leave us in peace, and we shall leave you in kind.
Cut the crap, Anders. I know what you are.
Don't let her hurt us. Please, we just want to go home.
There's something in the squint of his eye. You suspect he's lying.
Enough! Enough! I'll not play pretend anymore. Karlak, you're going home in pieces if needs must. And you, you'll soon learn what it means to ally yourself with the likes of this garbage.
Avernus was never my home. It was my prison. I'm free now. And I'm never going back!
Thank you.
my way.
Over there.
Training those children. You're so gentle. That's not how I was taught. I wouldn't quite say that. I learned the lesson after all.
I'm never going back. And if any of Mummy's little friends want to pick up where the others left off, they'll find nothing but a pile of ash. That's right, she won't. She can't. She couldn't even lay a finger!
Just try it, Zariel! Koba!
will. What was the Blade of Frontier's toughest kill? You don't mind if I don't ask to see it.
Felt good letting off a little steam after facing off with those ignots.
Granted, the fire lasted a little longer than it should.
Careful, soldier. If I burn any hotter, I might explode. Hear that? Infernal engine for a heart. Lets me burn as hot as the hells. Seems to be running in overdrive since I left Avernus. Won't be seeing my mechanic anytime soon, so I'll just make the most of the extra heat. Just don't get too close till I've found a way to calm it down. High pain tolerance and a dynamic duo of truly shitty bosses. But it's a bit early in the game to be getting into tragic backstories. Let's save the scar show for later, after we've worked up an appetite for tragedy. Meanwhile, I'll need to find someone who can tune up my engine sooner rather than later. Believe me when I say this thing is hot. The first time I faced down those paladins, they let slip there was an infernal mechanic in the area. A tiefling. He might be able to stabilize things, if I can find him. A weaponsmith, huh? Not sure if he's the guy, but I'd love to find out. A tune-up would do this rusty heart a world of good.
What am I to do?
Let's march!
All right, what now?
I wonder what the next move is.
I'd love to, thanks.
Let's get going.
Corpse is riper than a Minaurus bog.
gods are watching me.
What's the story?
Eat it!
Watch out. another crate. Just another crate. Swift as my feet can carry me.
Hungry for blood.
This'll be fun.
Looks empty.
Something's happening, but not enough something.
What's next? No time to waste.
Have a lot on my mind. And step carefully. There's a trap.
Don't be shy. Hop to.
I'll go this way.
Way too big. Do. everywhere. Accident or sabotage?
Goblins. What's next. Seems
Moll was as good as her word. She's reported that you've been threatening children. Your words may be false, but they ring truer than Moll's tales. You're off the hook.
She's coming.
Will, you've been naughty. And you know what happens when you're naughty.
God damn it. Anyone but her.
Will, you absolute stinker. You kept me a secret. Time to let the Hellcat out of the bag. Call me Mizora. I'm Will's patron, the fount of his power. My pet's been unruly, and his leash needs a yank. We had a deal, Will. But Karlak's still breathing.
I've taken more pleasant shits than you, Mizora, and at least those can be buried after.
That's no kind of talk for a lady. By the way, Karlak, Zariel sends her regards.
You told me! Devils only! She's a tiefling, not a monster!
How precious. The little pupster's found his bark.
Clause G, Section 9. Target shall be limited to the infernal, the demonic, the heartless, and the soulless.
Karlak meets the criteria by virtue of having no heart. Don't you worry. That ship has long sailed the Styx. But a defiant pup must still pay his price. To wit.
Will burns in the fires of Avernus. The lightning storms of Dis strike his flesh. His soul passes through each layer of the Hells, gaining their essence and their torment.
That's better.
What the Hells have you done?
A promise broken, a price paid. You know the terms.
Get used to the new form, pet. There's no going back. Some magic even I can't undo.
Now, let's see how the frontiers fare without their precious blade.
Karlak, keep an eye on him, would you?
I'll be keeping mine on you.
Oh, and Will, don't forget,
our pact still stands.
Ta-ta.
I'll be honest, soldier. I'm reeling. Will hardly knows me, but he chose my life over his. Been a long time since someone stuck their neck out for me like that. You can say that again. When he was chasing me through Avernus, I thought he was just another sad merc. How wrong I was.
God damn her, straight back to the Hells. Just look at me. I did what was right, and Mazora made me pay for it. I'd be hunting devils and demons, she said. Traitors and hypocrites, heartless evils of all sorts, but not... not Zariel's victims. Not innocent tieflings. All these years. You'd think it's a lesson I'd have well learned. It's Mazora who grants me the power to conjure armor and cast eldritch blasts. Before I was infected, I could even call hell beasts and summon festering clouds. But I promise you, every thrust of my blade and every flame I sparked was for the good of the coast. I can't utter the terms or circumstances of the pact. I can tell you most all else, but the pact, I'm forbidden. Unless Mazora permits it. But I'll say this. The moment I pacted myself to Mazora, I have not regretted for a heartbeat. It was my proudest deed. It was worth the sacrifice. All I can give you on that is my solemn word.
Go ahead. I'm listening.
Speak.
So, Will did the right thing, and it earned him a set of horns. Let that be a lesson to us all.
May the darkness protect you.